Welcome everybody to Luxury Benefits channel, and this video is about self-discipline and top 10 proven steps to master it. Self-discipline is one of the most important skills you will ever need for achieving your goals and to become successful. Self-discipline is one of the hardest things to master and implement in your day-to-day life. We live in a world full of distractions through which we push ourselves into the back. Listen carefully and pay attention to this video so you can master self-discipline and achieve your goals and make your dreams come true. It is not easy, but you can make it step by step. A wall gets built brick by brick. Same is self-discipline and wealth. You will not be able to overcome stairs in one step. You need to follow step by step with one step at a time, and you can go through easily. Most of the people are not willing to do what it takes to make their dreams come true. It is not only about your body, it's about your mind. To set your mind to sacrifice your immediate pleasure for the exchange of long-term result and achieving your goals and success. Number 1. Set your goal first. Your goal should be significant to change your life, and at the same time it should be attainable despite requiring a large amount of time, money or effort. If this is the first time you're experimenting with self-discipline, try a smaller goal, something attainable, but just a bit out of your comfort zone. Finding a goal was the easy part. Now it's time to analyze it and to split into parts. This is what most people never do. If you don't analyze and deconstruct the goal, it's no longer a goal, it's a wish. Anything you could possibly want can be divided into smaller pieces that, when put together, will form the bigger picture. Your job here is to identify what are the steps for your goal. For example, you want to learn a new skill. You need to find source of information to learn. Will it be books or video courses? Second step, to define time. When will the reading take place? Will you be reading in the morning or before you go into bed? Will you listen to them as audiobooks? How long it will take? As you can see, breaking down the goal into parts give you a better understanding of what you are about to do, what it takes to do, and how you can achieve it, as well as deeper understanding of why the goal is important for you. Set monthly milestones. They will act like mini goals, which when achieved, got you just a bit closer to the big goal. That way you will have a deadline right ahead of you, and it will make things a lot more easier for you. My advice to you: to pay attention to these milestones. Make sure they are attainable, but big enough to have you push for them. If they are too big, you will fail to achieve your monthly milestones and get demotivated to push forward. If they are too small, achieving them wouldn't get you closer to the goal, or it will take way long, which increases the chances that a third-party event will dismantle your project. Achieving your goal is a strategic play. There is no elevator to your dream life. You need to take the stairs, one step at a time. Number 2. Make a daily plan to follow. Looking at your goal, you will need to see what are the steps necessary, which will lead to achieving it. The more precise you are with the steps, the better. If your goal is to lose a specific amount of weight, you probably identified that main points are what you eat, what you drink, and how much physical activity you put into it. And number 3 is remove temptations or distractions. When deconstructing the goal, look for threats, things that could impact your journey negatively, and see what you can do to minimize or remove them completely. If you are dropping weight, don't have sweets in your house. If you plan on writing a book, don't start a new TV series. If you are addicted to watching a lot of TV, you could actively remove the TV from your house. So the only thing that left is to focus on your goal. You are in control of what you do, and look at temptations for what they are, things designed to keep you from achieving what you want. If you design your environment around your goal, your chances of achieving it increase dramatically. and the time until you do so is cut down by large amounts. Try to come up with backup plans for situations which you were unable to foresee. Number 4. Prioritize the goal before anything else. The goal you pick will change your life when you achieve it. That's the premise of this entire thing. This goal is probably the most important thing you can do right now, so it needs to be a priority. Everything else falls on the second place. Before you do anything else, you need to take care of your daily steps in order to reach your goal. You are the one who is in control of his life and his decisions. If the goal you choose could have that much of an impact on your life, why wouldn't you make it in your number one priority? If you are writing a book and some things come up, you first take care of your daily writing and then deal with whatever popped up. If you are losing weight and some friends want to hang out, you first hit the gym and then see your friends. The goal comes first. And number 5 is: don't wait for the perfect moment. Getting to where you want to be in life is not going to be easy. Actually, it's going to be really hard. That's why most people will never make it. That's why most people are average. Their lives are average, their relationships are average, they look forward to the weekend, because the other 5 days of the week they are miserable. It will require time, effort, money on a constant basis, and you are not going to be in a top shape for the entire run. You need to keep at it no matter what. How many people have you heard talking about how they are starting a new diet or quit smoking next week because they think it will feel alright? If you really want to be successful at whatever your goals is, you need to start now. The best time to start was yesterday, the second best is today. The world doesn't care about you, that's why you need to do it yourself. Number 6. Force yourself to do it. Some people don't understand that you are not only your body, you are your mind, and your mind controls your body. You can actively force your body to perform certain tasks if your mind is strong enough. An individual is defined by his willpower. If you are unable to control your actions, I'm afraid you are not in control of your life. It's time to put your foot down and take control. Every time you overcome one of the hard obstacles life throws at you, you will feel empowered and more committed to getting what you deserve. There will be days when you don't feel creative, snowy or rainy days when going to the gym will look horrible. Business hustles that doesn't seem to bring any result. You just need to trust your plan and keep pushing forward. In times like this, remember the goal, visualize it, rethink what it could do for your life, what it will feel like when you achieve it. That is what you are fighting for. That's why you keep on pushing. Number 7. Find role models who inspire you. The road will be long, and but be assured you are not the first that went through this. Many people who master self-discipline already achieve incredible results. There are the people at which the world looks in awe. They don't understand how someone could attain things that they themselves failed at in the past. Your goal is to find these people, study them, read their stories. Most of them will share the struggles they went through, and while others look at the end result. We suggest you look at the daily grind before they were even on the map to begin with. Those are the people who are living proof that your goal is attainable because they did it before you. Read about them, watch interviews and learn from them whatever you feel like the motivation is dropping. If they can do it, it means it's possible. It doesn't guarantee your success, but it's incredibly reassuring to know someone else walks the road you are walking and reach the same destination you are going for. Depending on what goal you set for yourself, find 3 people who have achieved greatness in this field and from now use them as your guiding compass. Number 8. Schedule your breaks, treats and rewards for yourself. If you get tired, learn to rest, not to quit. This is such an incredibly valuable insight that just by itself could change the way you look at life. Many people push and push and push until they get tired and then quit. The body needs fuel, the mind needs fuel, you need to recharge. If you are to attain your goal, you need to shift the way you are thinking about this. It's not going to be a sprint. Achieving your goals is a marathon. Your ability to properly understand the time and resources it will take to get there is crucial to being a strategic player. Dose of your energy and plan ahead for the times where you will feel down. It is important to keep yourself motivated. Do reward yourself when you overcome difficult tasks or when you are already covered a good portion of the journey. You've earned it, but don't let it race to your heart, because there is still a long way to go and it's easy to think you've got this in the bag. The rewards should be small parts of what the big goal will feel like. This way it will re-spark your inner flame and your appetite for greatness. Failure, even for one day, is not an option. The moment you decide to skip one day, it's the moment you sacrifice your goal. Believe it or not, achieving your goal objective required you to be all in of this hand from the beginning to the end. Number 9. Keep track of your progress. If you don't measure and keep track of it, you cannot improve on it. You need the data, and the only way to get at it by dedicating a portion of your time to it. Measure everything you can measure. That is how you will uncover the things that work and those that don't. Having this type of information will allow you to make educated decision and not shot in the dark hoping something hits. There are also side benefits to seeing that the effort you are putting in is actually showing result. Those small wins will motivate you to keep on pushing. I recommend you create a calendar where you record your daily activity. This type of action will also make it easier for you to adopt your new plan as a habit, since now, once you've done your task, you can check it off in your daily calendar. Challenge yourself to keep at it as long as you can, and it will add new layer to your journey. Number 10. Remove negative habits. Bad habits are time-consuming, destructive, and prevent us from achieving our goals. Habits become hard to break because they are deeply wired by constant repetition into our brains. Bad habits are also patterns of behavior, and it is the breaking of patterns that is the key of breaking the habits. Define the concrete behavior you want to change or develop. Identify the triggers and deal with them. One bad habit doesn't seem like a big deal. It's not going to make a big difference from day to day. But think about the damage it's doing long term. Think about how your life will be different in 10 years from now. If you get rid of the addiction now, how much better could your health be in 10 years? How would your financial life change? But just knowing about the formula is not enough. It's all about taking action. Take the first step today, and your future self will thank you for it. Thanks for watching this video to the very end. Subscribe to my channel, hit like button for the YouTube algorithm. I hope this video will help you, and we will see you soon.